Hello everyone and welcome to the Medivance webinar series hosted by Medivance Billing Service. Today's webinar is Biofeedback and Addiction Treatment. Does it work? We have a great presentation in store for you, but before we get started, I'd like to go over a few items so you know how to participate in today's event. Now, we have taken a screenshot of an example of the attendee interface. You should see something that looks like this on your own computer desktop in the upper right corner. Now, you have joined this presentation using listening on your computer speaker system by default. If you would prefer to join over the telephone, just select telephone in the audio pane and the dial-in information will be displayed. We have put all lines on mute to reduce background noise. If you have any concerns with audio or visual, please message me through the chat window located to the right of your screen. You will also have the opportunity to submit text questions to today's presenters by typing your questions into the questions pane of the control panel. And you may send in your question at any time during the presentation. We'll collect your questions and address them during the Q&A session at the end of today's presentation. Now, you will be receiving a link to review the recorded webinar in about 2 to 3 days. It is now my pleasure to introduce to you Rick and Chris Gallant of Biosound Technologies.
Thanks, Lakeisha. We appreciate Medivance sponsoring this and actually other webinars. We want to, you know, give kudos to Medivance for their advocacy for treatment providers. It's pretty refreshing to see a company, you know, disseminate that much information. So kudos to Medivance. I'm Rick Gallant. I'm the founder and CEO of Biosound.
And I'm Chris Gallant, president of Biosound, and proud to say that my dad is my boss and co-speaker of this webinar. So we're excited to go ahead and show you guys what we've put together for you.
And let me say that I'm proud of my son, too. Before we get started, we'd like everyone to take the opportunity to take advantage of something that we can offer. If you're interested, we know Moments of Change is right around the corner. But, you know, if there's somebody last minute wants to go to that, we do have complimentary registrations available. A limited amount for Moments of Change for Lifestyles Intervention Conference. That's in
October 8th, yeah.
1st of October, and then U.S. Journal Training is, I believe, the 23rd and 24th. You can find information for all three of those on our website. So if you are interested, we're going to let you know at the end of the webinar how you can acquire some complimentary registrations. So Chris is going to talk a little bit about the objectives that we hope we can achieve here during this webinar.
So some of the objectives that we hope that you guys get out of this webinar is that you'll learn about the effectiveness of biofeedback in addiction treatment. Another neat thing that we're going to do on the webinar today is attendees will be able to participate in a live biofeedback session. That's an HRV biofeedback session. So we hope you enjoy that as well. Participants will learn how biofeedback and sound therapy can be employed as an effective crisis intervention resource. And attendees will also be able to understand how biofeedback can be integrated with sound therapy and meditation to help achieve neuroadaptation or retraining the brain, creating new neural pathways. So what is biofeedback? Basically, biofeedback is a therapy that teaches clients the art of self-regulation, how to self-regulate. And some body functions we're able to control, but others are involuntary and are controlled by the nervous system, like our heart rate, our skin temperature, blood pressure. Those are a few examples. And using sensors, biofeedback programs are able to teach clients techniques to control these physiological functions. Usually a graph is displayed or a game is played on a computer, and feedback is given to the client as to how well they're doing at controlling those physiological functions. So they're given a score sometimes, and clients come back and they want to, you know, beat that score and improve their biofeedback session. So there are many forms of biofeedback, lots of different programs out there, different sensors, and all that different stuff's out there, but we want to keep it simple today. We're just going to go over a few different types of biofeedback and also give you a short presentation on one that we are very familiar with, that's HRV. And HRV stands for heart rate variability, and that's the variance in your heart rhythm pattern is what's being measured. So usually a finger sensor is placed on the client to monitor the heart rate, and every time their heart beats, the program will calculate their beats per minute. So if you look at the top graph, you'll see it shows a heart beating. So the first beat to the second beat, it shows is 70 beats per minute, and it's the program calculates that those beats per minute in milliseconds. So every time the heart beats, it's calculating the beats per minute. You can see the second beat to third beat, it's 76 beats per minute, and the third to the fourth, it's 83 beats per minute. So what this means, when you plot it on a graph, if you look to the right, you can see the graphs there. When that's plotted on a graph, it'll give you a heart rhythm pattern. So this isn't your pulse, this is an actual heart rhythm pattern, beats per minute over time, and it fluctuates. If you look at the top graph, this is a person who was doing a biofeedback session, HRV, who was frustrated, and you can see their heart rhythm pattern is very inconsistent in their variation. Their heart rate is kind of all over the place, up and down. And if you look at the bottom graph, you can see this is a person who was appreciative and grateful during their session, and you can see the difference between the two. There's a harmony there. That's where we want to be. It's called a high coherence state. High coherence is when you are physiologically in the zone. Athletes call it being in the zone. Your heart, your brain, your nervous system, everything works together in sync the way we were designed to work. So it just shows you how gratefulness and appreciation can change you physiologically, change your heart rhythm pattern physiologically. The third graph down at the bottom shows how all three relate. It's called the coherent state. So it shows you different rhythms. So that's a respiration rhythm, heart rate variability rhythm, and then the blood pressure rhythm. And you can see that when the heart rate variability is inconsistent or in a low coherent state, that's the first half of that graph, everything else is kind of with it. It's inconsistent, incoherent, not working together. And then as you make that shift, which is called quick coherence, your heart rate variability shifts into a coherent heart rhythm pattern. Well, so does your respiration. It follows suit, and so does your blood pressure rhythm. So that's what coherence is, and we're going to do a live presentation in a few slides here.
Yeah, I'd just like to add a short note to that, Chris. You know, as someone in recovery myself, you know, we've heard we've heard how important gratitude, and it's really amazing to be able to show a client how being grateful changes them physiologically, and that's what HRV will do. And it's pretty amazing stuff, and reinforces what we've told the clients out. You know, being grateful is gonna help you in your recovery. So I just wanted to add that short point there.
So the next form of biofeedback that we're going to go over is EDA, which stands for electrodermal activity. And EDA refers to the variation of the electrical properties of the skin in response to sweat secretion. So by applying a low constant voltage through the finger sensors, the change in skin conductivity can be measured non-invasively. Now our sweat glands are controlled by the sympathetic nervous system. So when we're under stress or we're emotionally aroused, we do sweat, which results in a change in skin conductivity. So this form of biofeedback therapy utilizes EDA as an indicator of the user's stress response, with the goal of helping the user to control their anxiety. So the ultimate objective of EDA biofeedback training is to improve the self-regulation of emotions and anxiety And you can see how this can be very beneficial to a treatment center if they can teach clients how to self-regulate when they feel anxious or they're under emotional stress. And the last form of biofeedback that we're going to go over today is EEG, or electroencephalography. It's also known as, more commonly known as neurofeedback. And this form of biofeedback is brain training. It addresses problems of brain dysregulation and allows users' brains to self-regulate or self-correct itself. Electrodes are applied to the user's scalp to detect brain activity at each site. Now, the signals are processed by a computer to determine brain frequency or electrical activity for each location that an electrode is placed on the scalp. Certain frequencies are good, and we do want to promote those frequencies, and then there's frequencies we want to diminish that hinder a person because they promote anxiety or show that the person has stress, anxiety, depression. So we want to diminish those brainwave frequencies. Now, their brainwave activity will change to more desirable brain frequency as the session goes on. So in this photo, you see a boy playing a game using his brain frequencies. The brain will learn to retrain itself if desired brain frequencies are detected. Undesired brain frequencies are detected. Neurotherapists use EEG biofeedback when treating addiction, ADHD, anxiety disorders, including PTSD and depression. So how does the treatment industry benefit from biofeedback? There's many ways that the provider, the treatment center itself, benefits. Clients become more manageable. And when we say manageable, they're able to manage their emotions and, during crisis intervention situations, we can avoid those and be more proactive versus reactive in that type of scenario. Also, improve patient focus during group therapy. They're more attentive during group therapy sessions. And then with a biofeedback program, you're able to document and monitor the process or the progress of the client as they go through your treatment program. So you have actual data that you can use to say, yes, this is working, or the things we are doing, the therapy and the biofeedback combined, it is working.
I just wanted to touch again on the management aspect of it with the clients. When we say manageable, we mean that if you can teach the client how to manage their emotions, they're not going to control them, but they can learn how to manage them, then they become more manageable as a whole, and it benefits the entire facility, not just the client. Helping them manage their emotions and that in turn their actions. So to regulate the anxiety, the pain levels, and the concentration, all those are benefits to the clients. And now we're going to actually do an HRV session, if you bear with us for a minute here. Now, this is something that everyone can participate in. We're actually going to monitor Chris. He's going to do a session, and it's going to teach the techniques that they actually teach the clients to use to go back to just that, managing their emotions and getting into the zone, getting more coherent. So this is the program, and it's a pretty simple, well-documented, plenty of science behind it. What we're going to do first is we're going to do what we call a coherence coach. Now, this is going to teach the techniques that we were talking about. We encourage everyone, every attendee and participant, to participate in this. You're going to, it's simple techniques that you'll be prompted to do. And you'll get the idea once we start that. Once you learn those techniques, and this is what we hope that the clients take with them, then they can play the games, they can look at the visualizations, and it all reinforces what we're doing. But we'll get into that in a little more in depth after the coherence coach session. So what we're going to do is open that session now. And Chris is now has a finger sensor on, and we're going to start the session. And again, we encourage everyone to follow along. You're going to be prompted to do some deep breathing to the ball sensor.
This is measuring heart rate variability again.
Hello, I'm your coherence coach. I'm here to teach you the quick coherence technique and show you how to improve your coherence scores with your M-Wave. Let's get started. The quick coherence technique is a simple three-step process. I'll take you through each step. First, I'd like you to focus your attention in the area of your heart, in the center of your chest. It's a gentle process where you can just feel your attention shift to the area of the heart. Got it? Now the second step is adding heart-focused breathing. Maintain your heart focus, and while breathing, imagine that your breath is flowing in and out through your heart. Try this for a few breaths to get comfortable with heart-focused breathing. Now set the breathing pacer to a comfortable pace. While maintaining heart focus and heart breathing, follow the ball. Gently breathe in through your heart as it's going up the curve, and breathe out as it's going down. Use the slider to set the speed of the ball so that you are breathing deeply, but easily. Once you've set the pacer to a comfortable level, just keep following the ball, inhaling as it rises, and exhaling as it falls. Now let's get to the third and most important step, the emotional shift. In order to enter a high state of coherence and comfortably sustain coherence, you need to feel a positive emotion. While maintaining heart focus and heart breathing, using the breathing pacer to guide you, try to feel a positive feeling. This could be a feeling of care you have for someone or something, a feeling of appreciation for the good things in your life, or an uplifting feeling you had at a special time or at a special place. Without trying too hard, just ease into a positive feeling while maintaining heart focus and heart breathing. Follow these three steps, heart focus, heart breathing, and heart feeling, to increase and sustain coherence. It's that simple. Continue practicing quick coherence while enjoying one or more of the animations and listening to the accompanying music.
Okay, so Chris is a pro. He's done this many times. You can see he went into a higher coherence state for 90% of that session. So the object, of course, is to move from a low coherent to medium to a high. Now, right now Chris is back in green, but you can see he's got a nice consistent heart rhythm pattern when he was in green, and then as he came out of that for a little bit, you can see the heart rhythm pattern again is a little more inconsistent. So what this shows is that when he got into the zone, remember we talked about gratitude and appreciation, so it shows that we changed physiologically. So we're more coherent, in other words, the heart, the brain, and the nervous system working in sync in that high coherent state, and the heart rhythm pattern doesn't fluctuate as much. You can see now he's down into the blue. However, you know, he could probably, If he just did the three techniques and stayed doing that, he could be in green 100% of the time. And in that case, it really is not going to do him much good to stay in the low challenge levels. So the program's designed to have different challenge levels, like anything else, to reinforce the fact that you can make this emotional shift. Now, I don't know. There's probably some of you out there who felt an emotional shift. If you didn't, then practicing those three techniques would do that. That's the heart focus, heart breathing, heart feeling. So what we would do on the next session is move Chris up to a medium challenge level. And that's just going to crunch the numbers more finitely and make it a little more difficult to get into a coherent state. So now he knows the three techniques, heart focus, heart breathing, heart feeling. So this is something that the clients really like. So what makes this program really interesting is the fact that the clients want to come back and do it, because it's once they learn the three techniques like you just did, they can play the games. And what we're going to do right now is we'll play one game called the garden game. So with the garden game, Chris is going to once again do the three techniques. I'm going to prompt you through it. Again, you're not going to be monitored or censored, of course, but I'm going to prompt you through it, and you can participate in this part of the session also. So what he's going to do is try to bring the picture to life, and we'll just start that.
And the longer I stay in a green, higher coherent state, the more colors and picture, animals and things the picture brings to life.
You'll be able to see the coherence down here on the bottom. As soon as it finishes calibrating, you're going to see the colors come in. And there you can see Chris is in blue, so that's the medium coherent state. And now he just jumped to green, so he's doing good with this game. And I spoke too soon. So there you go, Chris. Think about your baby. So you're gonna see the picture come to more and more to life, and it's pretty interesting. Okay, so now if you want to participate, you do the heart focus. So you're going to focus the attention. When I say you, I'm talking to everyone out there, all the attendees, of course. Focus the attention on the center of your heart. And now, do some deep breathing. Breathe deeply, but comfortably. And imagine you're breathing in and out through your heart. Keep your attention focused on the center of your heart. Breathe in and out through your heart. Okay, so now continue. Think about the ball pacer that you did on the last session. In and out, inhale, exhale, in and out through your heart. Now continue the deep breathing and think about things you appreciate in your life, things you're grateful for. This can be, of course, family, grandchildren, pets, vacations, the good times in your life. All these things affect us physiologically. You can see now that Chris is in green. He's doing great. And the colors and the animals are starting to fill in. You can see down here we monitor the coherence is monitored over here. You can see the percentages he's in. And of course, this is under circumstances. Typically, Chris would, this picture would be filled in by now. But you can see his heart rate's just a little elevated. But it's we're measuring the heart rate in real time. And you can see the colors coming in. We're almost there. He's in blue right now. So if he thinks about his baby, I think he might go into green. There you go. He's in green right now. And that's it. Wonderful. Keep trying. So under the circumstances, Chris, you did great. When you thought about your baby, that's pretty neat. It went to green. So that's how the program works. It's really interesting. Of course, there's different games. You can make the balloon fly around the world. You can fill up the pot of gold. These are visualizations down here. So basically, there's some background music. The client will see visualizations intensify as they attain and sustain coherence. This is pretty neat. Also, it's part of the program. If you wanted to go to this extent, you could use your own digital images of, you know, vacation, your family, whatever, all the things you appreciate in your life, and then pick some of your favorite really nice music. If it was me, I'd pick Louis Armstrong, It's a Wonderful World, and play a slideshow of my family, and then watch how it affects me physiologically. So this program is, like I said, there's a ton of science behind it. It's all in the program or online. If anybody's interested, we can send you to the website, but this is all part of the program. So it's multiple user. I don't know if we're leaving anything out, Chris.
No, I think we covered it.
Okay.
I mean, you can use this program to really track your clients as they go through the treatment process. You have the reports that can be printed out, so it's useful in that way too. And clients love seeing their progress. They love to improve their scores each time they come back and do a session.
And toward the end of the webinar, we're going to show you something that you can use, you can put into place as an aftercare, where they can continue this program. They can continue it outside of treatment. They can send you, and you can track their progress even when they're out of treatment. So we're going to continue now with the rest of the presentation of the webinar. So now we want to talk about Biosound therapy, which is what we are, what we do. So Biosound, basically, to make it simple, what we did was, if you think of bio as biofeedback and sound as sound healing techniques. So we've combined those two together and developed a program that has been pretty amazing in the last 4 years here. Basically, what you're looking at is you're looking at a client in session, and he's lying on a foam platform, which will deliver full body vibrations while he's listening to choreographed music with what's called binaural beats, and we're going to explain all those techniques. We're going to explain how we use guided imagery also in this, and how the biofeedback part of the program kind of melds with the sound therapy. There's really some interesting new developments with sound therapy, and we're gonna go through some of those.
So, what is biosound therapy? Again, we incorporated that program that we just did the live biofeedback session with. That's the biofeedback program we incorporated. It's HRV. We have music therapy, sound frequency vibrations, and guided imagery sessions, as well as videos that are played. And some of the music therapy that we have on the system is a drum therapy session where a subtle drum beat is played to relax in music to help the clients achieve a meditation. And the drum beat can be felt through the bed with the vibration, so it's really neat. We have a detox assist session to help clients who are early in the recovery process, as well as sulfagio meditations, and we'll get into detail about those, their healing frequencies. We have a chakra alignment session. So there's actually 11 hours of content available to play for the clients to help them achieve a meditative state. And then the guided imagery sessions that we have all relate to the underlying issues of addiction. It's somebody walking the client through a meditation on overcoming past trauma, releasing fear, guilt, and shame. These are the different sessions. Begin your transformation. And they're all filled with positive messaging and positive affirmations. So we're going to play a little video on how the whole system works, and we hope you enjoy it.
During the treatment process, a lot of clients will have anxiety, stress, depression, and we love to get them into the Bio Lounge to help them with those symptoms that they're going through, that they're dealing with. And a lot of ways we do that, we do a biofeedback session where they will learn a few techniques to shift from a negative emotional state, maybe it was an argument they had with a staff member or whatever it may be, that put them in a negative frame of mind for that day. But just doing a simple biofeedback session on the BioLounge really changes their outlook and gives them certain techniques to manage those emotions. Once the biofeedback session is completed, then the client can do a music therapy session, which incorporates vibrations, sound frequency healing, relaxing meditation, soothing music, to really bring the client down into a theta meditative state. Once they're in this state, then we will go ahead and deliver powerful meditations and positive affirmations to really change their mindset from negative thinking patterns to positive thinking patterns. And that's the goal that we have, is to really change the mind frame of the client as they go through the treatment process.
Okay, so we also have these videos on our website too, if it was a little distorted. Not sure how it comes out through a webinar, but you can visit our homepage and find these videos.
Okay. Who was that guy, Chris?
I don't know.
Okay, so this is solfeggio frequencies, and Chris is going to explain a little bit about this. What you're looking at is a chart that the solfeggios is what's incorporated in some of our meditation selections on the system.
Yeah, as I mentioned earlier, we do have the solfeggio frequencies embedded into the music that's played through the bed there. You can actually feel the vibrations of different frequencies through the bed, as well as hear the frequencies through the headphones. And there's six ancient frequencies that each resonate at a different hertz. And if you look at the energy tuner hertz there, that column on this chart, you'll see the different solfeggio frequencies. And the scale is 396 hertz, which is down in the red there, and then 417 hertz, 528 hertz, 639 hertz, 741 hertz, and 852 hertz. And each one of these frequencies has different healing properties and different healing benefits. And it's really interesting stuff that we've incorporated onto the Biosound therapy system. And we'll go to the next slide here on sound healing, which is another big part of why Biosound therapy is so effective. Biosound, so we already went over the bio part of Biosound, which is biofeedback, and then the sound healing is the other component to Biosound therapy. Sound healing uses audio tones and vibrational frequencies to repair damaged cells within the body. And that solfeggio frequency of 528 hertz is actually the frequency that geneticists use to repair damaged DNA cells. So, let's see here. Clinics worldwide use sound therapy to treat a wide variety of illnesses. And the compositions on the Biosound therapy system contain binaural beats and solfeggio frequencies to help the clients relax and achieve a meditative state. The Masaru Emoto study is a very interesting study that was done. Emoto took water samples and using different sound vibrations that he played to the water samples, he would freeze. After playing the sound vibrations to the water samples, different music and different sayings that he would say to the water, he froze those water samples and then viewed them under a microscope. And you can see the different pictures here, the effects that heavy metal music, the vibrations of heavy metal music has on just water molecules versus Amazing Grace. There's harmony there with the Amazing Grace photo. Same with the saying, "You make me sick," obviously is a negative saying, and you can see the effect that it had on frozen water molecules versus love and gratitude sayings.
Yeah, so I just wanted to add a little bit to this. When we say, you know, it's science is becoming more and more aware of the effects of sound on us physiologically. I mean, where everything is in a constant state of vibrations, and everything vibrates to its own frequency. So you know, this is called resonance, and you know, that affects our emotions, our mental states, and our overall health. So our own resonance recognizes that every organ, every cell absorbs and emits sound. So we can understand how specific sounds and frequencies can be used as powerful healing tools. And we're seeing that with results, real results, and we'll go over that too toward the end of the presentation. These are two excellent books if anyone out there wanted to delve a little bit more into using sound healing. Of course, Power of Sound, Joshua Leeds, I finished that book, it was great, and This Is Your Brain on Music, so that we can all relate to. It's just some really informative. It's a great, I know The Power of Sound is a great read. I can't tell you that I've read This Is Your Brain on Music, but I will get started on it. But I understand how music therapy works. But I do want to read that book. So those are two books that you could read. Now, the other key component in sound healing and in how we can bring clients into that theta meditative state so we can deliver the positive messaging is binaural beats. And Chris is going to explain how binaural beats work, and the binaurals are incorporated in our system.
Yeah, so many of our compositions, music compositions that we play on the system have the binaural beats. And basically what the sensation of a binaural beat is, it occurs when two sounds of nearly the same frequency are presented one to each ear, typically using stereo headphones, and that's what we do use with the system. And this produces a sensation in your brain of a third sound, and that's what the binaural beat is. And it's amazing what that effect has on the brain. Your brain will actually follow that frequency. And if you look at the top picture, top left picture, you can see 315 hertz is the sound that's being played in the left ear. And then 325 hertz is the sound that's being played in the right ear. And that results in a 10 hertz binaural beat. The difference in between the two is the 10 hertz. And so that person's brain, after listening to it long enough, will start, it's called brain entrainment, they will actually follow that frequency and their brainwave activity will come down to 10 hertz. So for this example, they would be in an alpha brainwave state after listening to 5 to 10 minutes of that type of binaural beat. The binaural beats that we use on our compositions are more in the theta brainwave state. We help clear the mind of the client and then deliver positive messaging once their mind is clear and the racing stops and they're in that theta meditative state. So that's how we use binaural beats with the Biosound therapy system.
Yeah, so the theta is the brainwave state right before sleep. So you can see delta, and that's the sleep state. Beta is what we're in right now, most of us. So. And alpha is a nice relaxing state. If you meditate, you'd be in alpha. So anyway, again, going back to the real therapy involved with Biosound is clearing the mind, stopping the racing thoughts, and then delivering the positive messaging. And binaural beats certainly helps with that.
We have another video we're going to play you on the provider benefits of our Biosound therapy system, so we hope you enjoy.
You're in the provider field, you're going to have cases where a client's going to want to leave the facility early, especially early in recovery. So what we found, the experience has been, is that
the therapist will keep their eye on the client, and they get into that state or get close to that state on the ledge. They'll bring them down, they'll put them into the system, and maybe do some nice music therapy, kind of subtle vibrations. And this will bring them down, and most of the time they want to do that experience again. So it helps with the AMA problems, with leaving early discharge, and that's a major benefit. It's become reimbursable also insurance-wise, so it could be a revenue stream for the company. So you can not only help your client, your facility can reap all the benefits of having a tool like this. That's the therapists really love it, because it will, it makes their job easier. We get the client into a better state of mind, where they're more willing to listen, to help them get started on their recovery. So they're more willing to listen to the therapist. They become more pliable, more manageable, and even the staff in the facility will use the system from time to time to de-stress. So most of our providers will allow their staff to take advantage of the system, within boundaries. So it's there's so many benefits to this. It's pretty incredible. The results we're getting and the feedback we're getting from virtually all our providers, and I've never been able to say this about anything that I've ever been involved with, but we have 100% positive feedback from our providers. And that's why we list them on our website. We put them on our website, and we encourage people to call any one of them. And they're going to hear the same thing from them as they're hearing from me right now. And it's just been an incredible blessing to be involved in this. And we're very grateful. Everybody involved in Biosound is very grateful for having the opportunity to bring this vital tool, another tool, another arrow in a quiver, if you will, to providers. And bottom line is the clients, to help the clients.
So who was that guy, Chris? we talked about preventing staff stress, so just real quick little amusement here. I'm sure a lot of you out there can relate to. That just helps. If the facilities allow the staff to de-stress, they're going to be more productive. So that's another benefit. We've kind of gone over this a little bit. Basically, go ahead, Chris.
Client benefits are great too. Not only the provider benefits, but the clients really get a sense of deep relaxation. Their stress and anxiety levels are reduced. We've heard a lot of times clients have a hard time meditating. I know there's centers out there that try to do group meditations, and that can tend to be hard for clients. And with the Biosound therapy system, the meditation becomes easier because of those binaural beats, and the subtle vibrations really help bring them down into that meditative state. Improve sleep for the clients, as well as pain management.
Yeah, I just wanted to add to the meditation part of it. After a session, it is the client actually receives the rewards of meditation, because they have that feeling. They're in that theta state. They're in that deep meditative state. So, the facilities will impress on the clients that, you know what, if you learn how to meditate, you can have that feeling. You can have that feeling anytime. So when you give somebody the rewards and they realize the rewards, it's better than trying to tell them, well, if you meditate, this is what happens. They just experienced it. So that's a huge benefit. And then we've heard improved sleep. Pain management, we've got some studies, initial outcome studies on that also. So what you're looking at here is a self-assessment form. And this is where the therapist or whoever's administering the session would have the client fill out the pre-session self-assessment form, and you can see we're measuring anxiety, stress, all the way down to muscle tension, headaches. And this is where this is where our data has come from, and at least the initial outcome studies we have. You can see that there's no numbers on the scale, and we did that intentionally. We wanted it to be as objective as possible. So in other words, this is the pre-session scale, and they're going to rate how they're feeling right now, of course, with the red being the highest. And then when they do the post, and they're not going to have a number in their mind saying, well, I should be down here. So we tried to make it as objective as possible. There's a couple of reasons to use the self-assessment form. And, one of them is that it can give the administrator of the session or the therapist or whoever an idea of where the client is and where they need help. And we do have suggested protocol. So we have different compositions are going to pertain to body aches and headaches and muscle tension versus, depression, anger, anxiety. So it's not set in stone, but it's a suggested kind of a guideline for what to use with the client. So those forms we furnish with the system. And then we wanted to go over some outcome studies. This is a study that was done in an all-women's facility over a three-month period with 27 clients. And you can see, this again is using the self-assessment. That's what we have to go by. But you can see the difference, is pretty drastic, pretty amazing, really, when you stop and think about it, when somebody's coming in and you can't do anything for them. They're red-faced. They're just so tense and tight. And to see the transformation pre and post session is amazing, when you can see it real life. But this is what we can show you now is the chart. And so we also measured emotions. So you can see there's a huge difference in being peaceful, of course, after the session, and some pretty good effects on the other emotions, being positive, happy, and excited. The pain we talked about, we have some anecdotal evidence, but this is again in the women's facility. You can see the back pain, neck pain, headache, and other. And so we have, we've heard a lot of how it is managed pain for people. We have people coming up to us at the conferences that we do where we have a system, asking to get in because they have a headache, they have back pain. So it's pretty amazing results with this. We told you about the aftercare. If you look there at the M wave, this is that portable biofeedback device that you could employ with the clients for personal use. I mean, if somebody's going to have to pay for it, they're a couple $100, but if they want to invest in their recovery, it's an excellent tool because it's got the same program with the games that you saw, and they can use it in front of the computer with the breathing pacer, the games, and all that. But they don't have to. They can use this anywhere. It's going to give them sounds and light tones and to signify their coherent state. So they'll have a breathing pacer on there. So they could use it, if they're in a car, they're in a trigger state, and they feel like the wheels are coming off, they got a tool to use. The other thing has just been tremendously successful for us. It's called the PAL, and that's a personal audio lifeline. We designed that because naturally the client can't take the unit with them. So we can give them everything but the vibrations. So we did load some of our material on there. We have hours and hours of all kinds of different material as far as guided imagery and dealing with phobias that could be downloaded. They're on our website. We also loaded the first three steps of the 12 and 12 in audio on there. So what the PAL is it's the headband with thin speakers embedded, so it's comfortable. You can wear it at night. You can sleep with it. It's got the MP3 player you see on the forehead there. And it's just been a tremendous benefit to clients. So we're having a lot of success with that as an aftercare product. Also, I just want to really quickly mention that all of the AA material is on our website, of course, complimentary to download to the PAL or to any device. So we have the big book and we have the 12 and 12 in audio on our website. So we're going to move on to the next slide.
Yeah. Yep. We think it's very important, the aftercare, once the clients get out of treatment, that they receive the proper aftercare. And we also want to show you some of the providers that we have. We're in detox facilities, women's facilities, adolescent facilities, so a wide range of treatment facilities.
Yeah, residential, IOPs, PHPs, you know, even dual diagnosis. So these are just a few. We have, you know, we have a map posted on our website. We're about 4 years now. We're integrated in over 70 facilities. We're approaching 100 units out there working every day, and that does my heart good because I know the benefits that people are getting from it. So it's just a great thing to be involved with. But we'll go to the next. So you know, just to summarize, you know, we all know that, you know, The disease is a disease of the mind, body, and the spirit. And the reason for us combining biofeedback and all the other, you know, the sound therapy, the guided imagery, is because we want to heal all three. So we heal the mind with the biofeedback and entrainment, and the body with the vibrations and music, and the spirit with a positive messaging and affirmations. And we have some powerful, incredibly powerful videos that we will play with the clients part of the session. Also, a typical session is about 45 minutes, by the way, and that's what's reimbursable. So we have, you know, we have information on how to document for that. Medivance is well aware of how to document for reimbursement, so you can help the clients and help your facility at the same time. So we're going to move to the next. Okay, so we told you at the beginning, and for anyone who wanted to, that we do have some complimentary registrations available, and you know, I think they're what, $300-$400 or something.
No,
yeah, they're somewhere around there. But anyway, we know Moments of Change is right around the corner, so you know, but if you want to go to that, and then we also have the USJT coming up and the Lifestyles Intervention Conference. That's out in Las Vegas. That's coming up 1st of October, mm-hmm. And then USJT. So they're all listed on our website under conferences to take advantage of a registration. Just go to our website. You can see it there, Biosound Healing or biosoundtherapy.com. Go to the contact page, fill out a contact form, tell us, you know, what conference you're interested in, and leave us your contact information, and we'll make it happen for you. And it's going to be first come, first serve, because there is a limited number.
Right.
So I guess we go to questions now.
If you guys had any questions, or if you didn't get your questions in, you can either call us on our phone number there, email us at system@biosoundhealing.com, or again, just visit our website and fill out a contact us form, which is on the home page.
All right. It looks like we don't have any questions right now. But again, yeah, if you think of something later and you want to ask them a question to Rick or Chris, you can call their number right there, 888-495-1946, and also email at system@biosoundhealing.com. All right. Well, we just want to thank you so much, Rick and Chris, and we want to thank everyone else for attending today's presentation. our webinar series hosted by Medivance Billing Service. Now, once you leave today's webinar, you're going to receive a survey on the presentation, and we'd appreciate it if you would complete the survey and provide us your feedback. You'll also receive a follow-up email within 48 hours with a link to view a recording of today's webinar, Biofeedback and Addiction Treatment. Does it work? On behalf of Biosound Technologies and Medivance Billing Service and our presenters, we want to thank you so much for joining us today and have a great rest of your day.